I am Molly, and this is How to Cook a Salad, and this is my guest, Chris, and we will be cooking a salad today. So, Chris, take it away here. Show us how we are going to be making this.
Well, thank you, Molly, for inviting me here to your wonderful kitchen. I've never seen a cleaner kitchen. You've got these fantastic plates, and there's cutlery, a refrigerator. We've got all these fantastic appliances, this wonderful appliance here. This is a unique situation we have going on tonight, and we got a fantastic recipe for you.
Perfect. All right. So let's see. We need to grab our lettuce over here.
Oh, very good. See, the great thing about lettuce like this that comes from the grocery store is they sell it bottom up like this. So you never want to expose the top or face of your head of lettuce to the sun until you're ready to eat it, which is what I'm going to do right now. This is an artificial sun. It's not the real sun, but it stands in for, you know, all the life giver known as soul in our universe. And on the lettuce too, you're going to have this hideous overgrowth. Have you seen this before? This
it looks nasty.
Have you ever eaten the outer part of a lettuce?
No, I don't want to eat that part.
Yeah, it's not very edible. Years ago, doctors used to take this part of the outer lettuce, and if for a sick person, they put it right under their tongue, and they'd have to hold it that way for a day or two. It would cure rickets. It would cure problems with your ankles. It would cure it if you were like bent over when you walked. Science has disproved all that. This part is useless. Don't have to eat it. So in fact, we're gonna take this off. We're going to work here. This is sort of our little surgery area, this plate here. We're going to work on it right here. So I'm going to start peeling this aside just like that. And just want to get rid of that there. Just make a pile. Oh, that's
perfect.
Fine.
Right
on the counter
there.
Here we go.
That's
good. And you want to count. It's going to make a weird sort of gross noise, just ignore
squishy.
That.
Thank you.
So this exposes the nice, fresh, edible portion of the lettuce head. And what you want to do now is get out your knife. This is a
fantastic.
It is a very sharp knife. It was made in China. It's a stainless steel knife, and it has a handle right here. You always want to hold a knife by the handle, never by the blade. That's only done in Scandinavia. So you're going to take the knife, and you have any preference in how I cut this?
No, but are we going to put it in the crock pot after?
Nope, no crock pot is needed for this recipe. So what we're going to do is we're going to cut right on into it like this. Make our first big cut like that, just like the scientists do. And then make another sort of quarter cut. You're going to take a quarter right out of this head of lettuce, just like that. So you got this nice sort of brick here, this nice quarter of lettuce.
A wedge.
That's called the 15-minute cut. That's the 15-minute cut. Make another 15-minute cut. That wedge right like that. Yeah.
Gotta be careful. I don't want to hurt it.
No. Yeah. Just be.
Don't
just
hurt
go.
Your head of lettuce.
Don't hurt the lettuce. Hurt the plate. That's what I say. So you're gonna cut again. Another quarter cut right there. That's good. And although you have technically you do have a quarter right here, I'll go ahead and I'll cut that into fourths. Wait a minute. Yeah. You'll cut that right there, just like this. You have these nice big chunks of lettuce, just like that. Now, what's next on the recipe?
I don't know. Let's see. We need maybe some tomato.
Tomato. There you go.
So here we go. And
this is fantastic. Why don't you
take this?
Tell us about the tomato, Molly.
Well, they're red and round, and we're going to cut it up and put it in a salad.
So why don't you go ahead and cut up that tomato for
perfect.
Us?
Perfect. All right, let's see. Start the front.
The tomato, see, that part is still edible. Don't worry, this is just a countertop.
We'll
it's not
it
hot
here.
Lava. It won't let's destroy the vegetable
part.
In any way. It falls off the plate.
And we'll keep going.
She's going to cut right into that tomato. Right. Notice she's cutting on a paper plate. Smart move. You can get rid of the paper plate plus the counter. It's hard.
And all the mess.
It'll absorb the shock. She's going to cut right through that tomato. Do you enjoy tomatoes?
No, I don't. Uh-oh.
Not a lot of people do. We only include them in recipes for their color, for their shape.
6 or 7 years old. Don't eat tomatoes.
I would say, on average in America, per year, annual basis, only one person eats a tomato each year in America.
All right, not the prettiest, but here we go.
Oh, fantastic.
Have our tomato here, so.
And we're going to get out these tongs. We have these tongs, and I'm going to arrange these slices of the tomato here in between the wedges of the lettuce.
Perfect. So one
like
for
right
each.
On there. Just imagine, although this is a vegetarian meal, we're going to pretend that these slices of tomato are slices of roast beef that we're applying to the sort of the bread of the lettuce, the bun. These are lettuce buns, right? We're making just like that. And we'll put another one here. Put another one here. Just like in
perfect.
There.
Perfect. Beautiful.
And we're just like,
it's all about the presentation.
It's just like the presentation. We're going to actually hand. Very good. And finally?
Some cucumber. Let's go for cucumber.
Very good. We have the cucumber here. What we're going to do is actually have a plate to work on this right here. Okay. And what should I do with the cucumber?
I think we have to peel it first. So we'll go ahead with our knife.
We're going to peel
and
it.
And peel some of it. And then we'll go ahead and cut it and put it on the
there was, this was part of a wager that we could only use the knife and the tongs to prepare our meal. So we it's very difficult actually to peel a cucumber with a knife. So in this case, here's one method of peeling a cucumber with a knife. So first, I'll make a couple diagonal cuts. These are diagonal cuts. It's not a horizontal or a vertical cut, but it's sort of a this way, a tic-tac-toe victory either way. So I'm going to cut diagonally. Notice the peel is still, it's still intact on the cucumber. We don't want that, do we? But we're going to peel these after we've cut them. Now, the way we do that is, here, why don't you just take that right over there in the lettuce bed.
Perfect.
Let it put,
save
and,
that
and
for
if
later.
You could, if you could, take a piece of the lettuce.
Cover it.
Yep, tuck
it's
it in.
It's going to get cold.
There we go.
Perfect.
You don't want that. So no. Back over here, if we're gonna peel these, and I'm going to come over to this center plate here to peel these.
Ooh.
You've laid it down like this, and now you're going to stick the knife in, and you're actually going to cut around the perimeter of
this
the...
This is fancy. And if you cut your finger a little bit, it just... adds to the flavor.
It does.
Don't worry.
A lot of needed protein and red blood cells.
Yes.
So we're going to slice all the way around the meat of the cucumber.
Beautiful.
Now, depending on how big your cucumber was, how many slices you got, the peeling process could take up to 18 hours. So you want to set aside some time for that. And if you could just get rid of that. Thank you.
Right cover this one up too.
Mm-hmm. Now, because it does take quite a while, I'm only going to do the half of one more of these and actually leave the peel on the rest of these little friends. There we go.
Beautiful. Right.
There all we right. go. And we'll just pretend that we peeled the rest of those. And
so now, how do we put them on here?
How do we put it
how
all
do we
together?
Put them on there?
That's
all
the
right,
question.
Let's see.
That's the question I have.
Get it all together.
We have the tongs. Why don't you take these?
I will take those.
Okay. And we're going to bring over our lettuce bed. Remember, we treated these as buns with imaginary vegetable meat. And now I'd like you to take both the lettuce quarter and the tomato beef and set it right on the plate next to the cucumbers. Right ahead there.
Perfect.
There we go.
All right.
Look at that. Now, if you're doing this for a party or for a family that's gathered, you never want to cook in front of people. You don't want to give away your secrets, sort of like a magician school sort of thing. You want to do this behind closed doors. And if you do have family that insists on being in the room, you want to turn to them and say, go ahead and close your eyes. Close your eyes. And they'll keep their eyes closed for the duration of the cooking, maybe longer. You know, you could leave. You don't come back. You could turn the lights on. They'll obey your every command. You are the parent. And then finally, we're going to take these cucumbers, and we're going to add these just like that.
Perfect. That was great.
So we have this fantastic salad. And now, if you would, Molly, I believe you have a fork.
Going to go ahead and try our delicious salad here. So mm-hmm. You'll take a little bite. I got to go around our icky tomatoes here. Pretty good, Chris.
How does it taste?
Good job.
How does it taste?
I like it.
When you taste it, what do you think of? What colors come to
rainbows
mind?
Rainbows.
All the colors.
The galaxy.
Now, is this something you'd prepare at home?
Absolutely.
Is this something you prepare for the boys, for
absolutely.
The kids at home?
Yes.
When they're rowdy, they're jumping after school, you got to calm them down.
Imaginary kids.
Very good. One other important tip with this meal and any other meal, you don't want to leave it out overnight. It'll attract ants. It'll attract worms, roaches.
Squirrels.
Squirrels are a deadly threat in Michigan this time of year. They're looking mm-hmm. for food to last them through the winter. Do you like squirrels?
Love them. Perfect.
Perfect.
But not for my food.
Like perfect, God's perfect creation
their
is a
tails,
squirrel
so
in many
adorable.
Ways. In many ways it is.
Yes. Absolutely.
But not in the kitchen, as we've stated. You don't want any squirrels or rats or salamanders. A lot of kitchens in Michigan have salamanders. Michigan was originally a swamp stolen from the Indians. It's cursed. So you want to put this away at night. And the way you put it away is right under the counter. Put it away completely.
Into a refrigerator here.
Okay. And we'll get rid of this plate here. And once you take that scrapings and just dump those right in the can.
This is for you here.
There we go. And there we go. Just dump that right in. Your mic cable will reach. Very good. Okay. And it's as if that we didn't do any cooking at all. Nothing took place here today. It's
easy
really
cleanup.
Just
yeah.
It's just that easy.
It's just that easy. Well, thank you, Chris.
Thank you, Molly.
I appreciate you being here.
This
it was great.
It's been a revelation.
More great recipes to come, I'm sure. So,
more to come.
Thank you very much. And everybody can have a good night.